So today we'll start the remaining two sections related with the principles of economy. Yesterday I talked a little bit about the use of the human body, that was the first factor, and then the arrangement of the workplace and the design of the tools and equipments. So although this is the part of the ergonomics, but here it is related with like few process charts, that's why it is being covered. Like two-hand process chart and the SIMO chart. So those two are related with this somehow. That's why we are talking about this. Otherwise, this section is related with the ergonomics only. So here, as I said, this is primarily related with the ergonomics, but since it is useful in some of the process charts, that's why I'm talking about this right now. So here, the use of the human body, the workplace arrangement, and the design of the tools and the equipments, these are the three important parts. So regarding the use of the human body, any work should be designed in such a way that it involves the particular way of using the human body. So it is about the designing of the work methodology in such a way that there are more curved and continuous movements instead of the straight line motion, which are more difficult and needs better, more control. Use of the lowest practicable classification of the body part. Actually, this is about the use of the lowest classification, practicable, whatever is the allowed one, that classification of the body part should be used. So what is this classification? I will talk in the next slide. Both hands should begin and end their motion at the same time. These two are related with the two-hand process chart, related with the two-hand process chart. These are used in two-hand process chart, how to come out with the better methodology of doing the work, so that the ineffective time can be eliminated and the productivity can be enhanced. So both hands should begin and end the motion. Both hands should not be idle except at the rest. Okay, and hand motion should be symmetrical, simultaneously, and towards the body or away from the body. So whether the both movement of both the hands should be simultaneous, symmetrical, either towards the body or away from the body. Okay, so as I said, the classification of the movements with regard to the use of the body parts which are used. So the class one is most preferred one. If it is possible, then this should be used wherein the pivot is knuckle and the body member used is the finger. Okay, then the next class is the two. Pivot is wrist, and in this case, hand and finger both are used. Then third class is class three is the elbow. Pivot is elbow, and it involves the use of the forearm, hands, and fingers. And then next four class four is the shoulder. Pivot is shoulder for class four. Body parts, a class four movement. The body parts used are the upper arm, forearm, hand, and finger. Okay, and the class five is for the class five movement involves the various body parts, maximum number of body parts. Here you can see the pivot is a trunk, and the body parts which are moved is torso, like entire upper body part, upper arm, and forearm, hand, and finger. So you see, the idea behind talking about these classification is the higher the classification of the movement being used, greater will be the efforts that need to be put in and so greater will be the fatigue. So efforts are always made to use the lowest classifications so that as far as possible, so that the related efforts and the fatigue can be reduced. So as far as possible in designing the work, the lowest classification movement of the body parts should be used. So that is what was there in, as I said, use the lowest practicable classification of the movement so that the fatigue associated with the work is minimized. Okay, so this is the same thing what I have already said. Now, like if we have to work against the gravity, or if the momentum use is possible, then efforts should be made to design the work in such a way that whatever momentum associated with the handling of tool, work piece, etc., whatever is associated with, so the momentum should be used to assist the worker so that efforts in doing the work can be reduced, and then the different fingers have the different capabilities. So depending upon their capability to handle the force, the work should be designed. For example, the middle finger and the thumb should be used for handling the heavy load, as these are the strongest fingers. So while the index finger, fourth finger, little finger are good for the light loads only. So based on the capability of the body parts, the work is designed. Like say, still if the heavier load is to be applied, then hands may not be good enough to apply, and we may use for applying the brake in cars, so we use the legs. Similarly, for operating number of machines also, we use the legs to apply force. So if depending upon the load or the force to be applied for successful performance of the job, the suitable the design of the work, design of the machine or equipment is done in such a way that the body part is able to handle those loads and forces effectively on the long run. Okay, so that's what I said. Wherever possible, use of the feet should be arranged because they can apply heavy force, and the less fatigue will be felt in, and it should be twisting motion should be performed with the elbow. So this is fine. So these are some of the points related with the use of the body parts of the human being and the designing of the work considering the capabilities of the body parts. Okay, the another one is the designing of the workplace. This designing of the workplace can be anything. It can be the bench over on which the assembly work is being done. It can be tailor shop. It can be assembly shop. It can be simple clerical work. So where what will be placed, where what will be arranged, it is about that only. This also involves the study of the physiology and anthropology related aspects, because it is related with the design of workplace. So physiology and anthropology, these are the two other areas also which need to be studied or need to be considered while designing the workplace. I will talk about some of these now also, but in detail we will talk when we'll take up the ergonomics related thing. Then designing of the workplace, few important points where these points are such that if these are kept in mind, then efforts related with the worker efforts needed by needed from the worker to complete a particular job, that will be reduced. He will be feeling less fatigue. So that's how you can say the principle of the motion economy is being applied. So the fixed location for each tool and material, there has to be an identified place for tool and work material. This will reduce the time as well as efforts in searching and selecting. By default, like in home, in the night, even when there is no power, there is no light, you can find the things if you have identified place for a particular thing. So you can find the switches, you can find the torch, you can find anything that you regular a place that you regularly use for putting in the things. So a fixed location for each tool and material will eliminate the search and the select. Then the gravity bins or drop deliveries should be used to reduce the efforts related with like reach and move time. You need not to worry about how and how these will be placed in. Use the gravity bins or the drop deliveries. So efforts related with the reach and the move times that can be reduced. All the materials and tools should be located within the normal working area. This is an important thing. What is normal and what is maximum working area? And this is also called most preferred area. Most preferred area in which the most used things are placed. Most important things are placed. There are various principles based on which we try to arrange the different controls, different visuals, different panels in this normal working area, and these should be closed to the point of use as possible. So whatever things need to be used, they should be as close as possible, so that efforts in using those tools, materials, work pieces are reduced. So all materials and tools should be located in the normal working area. So what is this normal working area? Let me talk about that first. So you see, this is what it is showing. Like in the normal sitting position, this is the work table, right? This is the work table area, bench, you can say. From this the forearm section, from this elbow to this the fingertip, this area, so whatever this the forearm section can cover, that area will be the area for, this is say for the left hand, and likewise right hand will have its own normal working area. In this case, you have not to stretch your upper arm, no need to stretch the upper arm. So in normal working area, basically we use finger, wrist and the elbow movements only. It's a class 3 kind of the classification of the movement. So we try to arrange most of the workpiece, tools, controls, materials in such a way that they fall in this area, so that worker has not to stretch the arms and unnecessarily put in more efforts. So this is one normal working area. This is called normal working area. Okay. And what is the maximum working area? Now you can see here itself, the one hatched section, this shows that if you place your this hatched section is falling in the normal working area for both the hands. Okay, so this is the most preferred thing, then the second most preferred areas will be like this. So it will be the best if we can arrange the things here. So either left hand or right hand you can use to access this area. Likewise here also, after stretching the arm in full, okay, involving the shoulder movement, this indicates what will be the reach of the left hand side. Okay, like this, and this is indicating the reach of the right hand side, right? And this is just corresponding to the normal working area, and this is corresponding to the normal working area of the right side, okay? And the area which is common to both, reach of both left hand and the right hand, is this one. This the cross hatched area, this indicates this is the area which is within the reach of both the hands, okay, within the reach of the both the hands, in stretched arm condition. So the left hand maximum working area, right hand maximum working area, this is the same what we have talked, normal working area, okay. So when work is place is designed, this maximum work area should be, use of the maximum working area should be minimum as far as possible. The tool workpiece and the material should be arranged in the normal working area, and the things which are rarely used or less frequently used or not of that much importance, they can be placed within the beyond the normal working area, but within the maximum working area. Okay, so this less important, less use, or less common, less frequency of use, those things you can say can be arranged, the tool material and the workpiece which are of less importance, less common in use, can be arranged in the maximum working area beyond the normal working area. Okay, now going back to the our earlier, this is where I had left. These should be arranged as close as possible within the normal working area or beyond the normal working area as per the case. So there are different principles associated, principles which are used in identifying how to place, what is to be placed where. So like use, importance, frequency of use, there are many things which are used as a governing principle for identifying the location of the controls, tools, materials, etc. Okay. The design of the workplace, other points related with the design of workplace includes like the work table height should permit the alternate sitting and standing. This is important to avoid the monotonous aspect, or to have the better relaxed working. Okay. So the height of the table should be adjustable, or it should allow the working both in standing or in sitting position. Obviously, the illumination related aspects like glare free adequate lighting with the proper ventilation and the proper temperature. So we'll talk in detail about the illumination, ventilation and temperature, the kind of things that are needed. Otherwise, the work is adversely affected, worker may feel more fatigue if these things are not there. So we'll talk in detail about this later with the ergonomic section. The design of control and display devices, this is also the part of the ergonomic section. So these should be designed in such a way that these are easy to use, these can be quickly read, and chances for the error are less. Okay, so depending upon the scale, the different kind of the displays are used. These can be fixed scale, or these can be fixed pointer, both kind of things are there. And then the digital display, certainly digital displays are not that useful if the data is changing extremely fast. So depending upon the situation, depending on the kind of data, the way by which it is changing as a function of time, the different type of the display devices are used. Okay, so that was about this is the same diagram showing, both are showing like here it is with the dimensions only, the kind of like 60 centimeter for a common case, and this is the 30 centimeter, and this normal looking area is 40 centimeter. Okay, so the 60 centimeter, 40 centimeter, and so these are the like the reach associated with the normal working area or maximum working areas, you know. There is another interesting diagram about which I didn't talk so far, that is about this one only. So where what is to be placed, the earlier diagram or whatever I have shown, this was related with the horizontal, the reach on the horizontal plane, and here it is about the vertical one. So this is indicating the normal for the forearm, okay, like this, and the for upper arm it is going like this. Okay, now going back to the third aspect related with the principles of motion economy. So what it says, the design of the tools and the equipment, there should be proper color coding. There are different techniques of coding the control devices. You must have heard there will be certain like red, green, yellow. So there is a purpose behind the coding, or color coding, or texture coding, size coding, shape coding. There are different ways of the coding of the control devices. So use proper coding of control devices so that the function is error free. You need not to read very carefully each and every time, and that is why you'll see the people use different kind of the colors in simple, like the forms of the different colors. So they will simply say green color or blue color or yellow color, the form is to be used. So that is easy to communicate and easy to use. So this maximizes the speed as well as the minimizes the error. So if the proper coding is done, proper coding of the control devices is done, it facilitates the faster application as well as reduces the chances of error. Then all levers, handles and wheels and other control devices should be located in the most preferred area. This is the like in the normal working area, and these should be located in such a way that there is a possibility of use of the mechanical advantage. So using less force, the work can be done. Try to avoid the use of the manual force for doing the job. So wherever possible, use jigs and fixtures to hold the parts and components so that it fastens the job or the operation, or use stop guides to reduce unnecessary control positioning. Okay, there are other aspects related with the design of the tools and equipment, like the design of the workplace layout involves the is the part of the ergonomics only. So but anyway, we'll talk about the few highlighting points, like determination of the work surface height, designing the operator chair, permitting the use of anti-fatigue mats for standing the operator, determination of location of tools, materials and control devices in such a way. So these are the different things which will be falling under the scope of design of tools and equipments. Okay, so the two hand process chart basically basically it is a process chart only. Okay, so two hand process chart. Okay, this we commonly write it as a THPC. So if you see, this is also a kind of process chart. This is a process chart. So all process charts, whether it is man, material, machine type, they indicate the various activities, right? Activities happening in a particular sequence, happening in sequence. So you can say it a detailed form of the flow process chart of the man type, but the way by which it is developed, that is completely different. Since it has similarities related with the flow process chart, FPC, flow process chart, that is why I am saying that there is this is a kind of process chart which shows the activities happening in a particular sequence. So this is primarily used, so we can say THPC is primarily used to record the activities of workers, hands or legs. So depending upon the work, one can use one leg or both the legs or one hand or both the hands, and these are recording. THPC used to record the activities of workers' hands or legs to show the relationship with one another, right? Or relationship with each other. This is not necessarily drawn in time scale, but it is common to draw this on a time scale so that one can identify what is the portion of the time in which the hand or the leg is moving or it is static. So it helps to quantify the time. Okay, so this is usually, you can say, usually drawn on time scale, so that you can easily show what is the period for which, what is the time for which left hand is working, what is the time for the right hand working. Okay, so when the recording of the two hands movement on a common time scale is done, it shows that the actions of both at any moment of time, any moment of time, which means what is the portion proportion in which both the hands or legs are contributing or they are not contributing. Okay, since it primarily involves the recording of the actions of hands and legs only. Okay, so because of this, it doesn't involve any other activity like the movement of the worker from one place to another, that is not recorded here, or the component is lying somewhere idle, or component is in storage. It is used to record the actions of hands and legs. And another thing, that it is primarily used to record the activities which are highly repetitive in nature. Repetitive in nature. Okay, so just like cutting of something, packing of food in a sweet shop, packing of sweets in a sweet shop. So repetitive jobs which are short cycled, short time cycle job are primarily studied, wherein the coordinated movement of both the hands and the leg is involved in successful completion of the work. Okay, so the recording is in more detail. So the repetitive jobs of the short cycle in nature, since this the THPC is in much more detail as compared to the flow process chart. Why and how? Because you see, in conventional flow process chart, what we have seen is operation, then there was a travel, then there was an inspection, and then delay and storage. This was further in detail, like FPC was also in more detail as compared to the OPC, outline process chart, where we had just used operations and symbol. So what we are saying, THPC is in further detail. So this is OPC, this is FPC, and if we talk of the THPC, this is further in detail, and what it does, only the operation, you see, operation cutting a metal is one operation, but what are the different actions of hands and the body parts are involved, hands and legs are involved, that is not being recorded. So that is recorded in THPC. So one operation of the flow process chart in THPC can be broken down in number of the elements. So here one operation, these are not shown, like transport, inspection, delay and storage, these are not shown in THPC. THPC primarily used to show what is being done during the operation by the two hands. So THPC is more detailed about the way by which the two hands and the legs are being used in performing certain operation. So the operation is broken down in number of elemental activities for constructing the THPC. So THPC is a little different from flow process chart, but still it shows the different activities being done in sequence. Okay, that is why it is process chart, since it shows the activities during the operation of hands and legs in sequence to complete the particular operation. Okay, so the THPC, in THPC, the different particular operation is broken down into the number of elemental activities, and these activities are shown in THPC. So the symbols which are used in THPC are similar to what we have seen in FPC. Symbols for THPC, these are largely similar to what we have seen in FPC or flow process chart, but they have completely different meaning. Okay, say here also we use O for operation. Okay, so one operation of FPC is further broken down into the number of elemental activities, and again we are saying as a operation, right? So what is the meaning of operation in manual jobs which are being done by the two hands and the legs? So the operation is used for the activity of, like activities like grasping, okay, positioning, then using certain things, the releasing, releasing the tool, workpiece, or material can be anything, like the grasping the tool, workpiece, or material, positioning the tool, workpiece, or material, using the tool, workpiece, material, etc., like this. Okay, so all these things are termed as operation. Okay, then we use the in THPC, we use the symbol like transport, but it is not like movement of worker or material from one shop to another or one machine to another. This movement, again here it is termed as a transport only, but it represents the here in THPC movement of hand or leg, okay, to or from, again the same thing, workpiece, tool, or material, like the hand or leg is approaching or moving away from the workpiece, tool, or the material, then transport is used. Okay, then delay here has a different meaning, like it is used to shows that the like left hand is working but right hand is idle. Okay, so when the hand, particular hand or a leg is idle, then it is charted as a delay. Okay, and then storage, here storage is redefined as a hold. Okay, so this is not a storage like in flow process chart, but it is used to show the holding of like tool, workpiece, or material during the operation, like when cutting is being done. So the left hand is holding the workpiece and the right hand is performing the cutting. Okay, so the holding of tool, workpiece, or the material is shown by this inverted triangle, that was denoted as a storage earlier, now it is hold. So in THPC, these four types of the symbols are used with the different meaning. Okay, so when any the job is studied, you see, a short cutting job, short workpiece cutting job, or the food packing job is studied by the study man, then what it can find the study of the job by THPC gives the greater finer details of the job being done by both the hands or legs. Okay, so after the study we may find that one hand is most of the time idle, or the legs are not at all being used, or the more difficult coordination exists at this stage. So let us come out with a different way of doing the things, different methodology of performing the job, so that an improved method can be developed wherein the time is done in very very quickly, where the job is done very quickly with the lesser effort. So after the study of a short cycled job, okay, we may come out with a newer way of doing the things which requires lesser or fewer movements or fewer activities or fewer time, fewer efforts. Okay, so even the short cycle jobs, which is say 10 second is the total job cycle, maybe doing but the 10 second short cycled job is to be done say thousands of the time in a day. So if improved methodology of doing the work is helping to cut down the efforts especially, then the fatigue of the operator can be reduced. It may not help significantly in terms of the time, but in terms of the efforts, certainly this can be of the great importance to reduce the fatigue of the operator. Okay, so lesser movement, lesser activities, lesser time, lesser efforts, so those are the beneficial things. So how it is developed, let me give some idea. It is just like flow process chart only. So here we'll be writing the it is like this. So we can say here first time scale, okay, then the activities of the left hand, okay, then activities of the right hand, okay, like this. So when say this is the time scale, it can be anything 10 20 30 40 50 60, okay. Then you just mention what is being done here and what is being done by the right hand, then what is being done by the left hand and right hand. So keep on the recording the the activities. First, the activity list is to be identified. So details of the job in terms of the activity is identified. This is one. And thereafter we'll be doing the charting. Okay, so first on the common time, so first we record the different things being done by the left hand and then the right hand, then charting is done. So how to, so this is more important thing, first to come out with the details of the job and the activities being done by both the hands or the legs. So how this part is done, thereafter based on these activities the suitable chart is developed for the right hand, for the left hand and for the right hand on a common time scale. So we can see if something is being done by left hand but nothing is being done by the right hand. Okay, so we can identify and how many, so number of activities to be done, what is the total time it takes. So, and after that you can rework for rework on the newer method to see in improved method how many activities are needed and what will be the time to complete the job according using the improved method. So this is how this is what is the bigger idea about the THPC structure, how it is developed. So since this the job is very short cycle, okay, so it is important that certain things are kept in mind, otherwise we will miss number of things. So what are those? Say the first thing is study the operation cycle. What are the different things involved in doing a particular job, and this has to be done number of times. Study the operation cycle number of times, okay, so that you can identify what are the different components, like hand moves towards the tool, okay, then grasp the tool, then hands move to the workpiece, then the workpiece is moved towards the fixture. Then the cutting is done. There can be number of the small elements. So considering our symbols and their meaning, break the job into the number of elemental activities, and that is possible only after thorough study of operation cycle number of times. Okay, the second thing which is done, develop a list of the activity being done by one hand at a time. So what we say basically, record or chart the activities of one hand at a time. Okay, so this is the, otherwise we'll mess up completely, we'll mix the different things. So what left hand is doing, that will be recorded, or what right hand will be doing, that will be recorded at a time. Okay, if you are after recording of the activities of the left hand, we'll be doing it for the right hand, say, just for an example. And one more thing, do not record more than few symbols. So just record, say, operations or the transport or the hold or the delay. It was there related with the THPC. So record very few the symbols or the elemental activities while doing the charting, so that there is a clarity what has been recorded and what will be recorded thereafter. Okay, identify or determine, identify the fixed or definite start, definite start or end of the action or the cycle. So there has to be a particular definite start or end of cycle. So like identify a fixed or definite start or end of the cycle. It may be just like picking up something can be a definite start, or dropping the job is the, like say, definite end of the cycle. So that you assume that this is the beginning of the cycle or this is the end of the cycle. Okay, record the action at the same level, at the same level, if they occur same time, right? Say something is happening, something is being done by the left hand and then right hand. So if say this is the activity, the time 30, so something is being done by the left hand, so that will be recorded here. At the same time, if right hand is also doing, then it will be recorded on the right hand side. It may be anything like operation transport, or it may be delay, or it may be storage. So depending upon the case, what if the something is happening at the same time in both the hands, something is being done by both the hands, then it will be recorded at the same level. If the things being done by both the hands in sequence, then they will be recorded at the different level. Okay, so what we can say, the actions which are occurring in sequence should be recorded at the different levels. Okay, so actions occurring in sequence should be recorded at different levels. Okay, so this is how the charting is done. Okay, so here I have one example related with this. Maybe I can finish it very quick. This is an example of cutting off the tube. This is the glass tube. This is the zig. Okay, so the left hand holds the glass tube. Okay, left hand holds the glass tube and then presses it against the zig, and then marking is done. And after the marking, the notch is made by the file. Okay, and then the tube is taken out for cutting purpose. So this is the kind of the job when it is improved. I'll talk about this in detail in the next term. And when the job is improved, it requires just three steps. When the zig is the zig design is improved, it requires a very fewer number of the steps as well as the lesser time. Earlier total activities were like 14 and now it is reduced to 3. So it a lot of things are possible through THPC. About this example I will talk in the next lecture.